Greetings everyone. I'm Dr. Shefali from Shri Guru Ram Rai Institute of Medical and Health Sciences, Dehradun. Today I'm presenting a case of 14 years old female with a rare trio of congenital anomalies. So starting with the first one is the bronchopulmonary sequestration. It is the abnormality of the respiratory tract consisting of aberrant formation of non-communicating segmental lung tissue with an incidence of 0.15 to 1.8%. Second rare anomaly we found in the patient was situs inversus. It is also a rare congenital anomaly with transposition of the thoracic and or the abdominal viscera. Third in line was pectus excavatum. It is the most common anterior chest wall deformity characterized by concave depression of sternum and interior ribs. The presence of an intralobar pulmonary sequestration along with dextrocardia and pectus excavatum is a rare occurrence with a possibly undefined histogenetic association, only being sparingly published as a case report in the past. Discussing the case, a 14 years old female came to the hospital with complaint of hemoptysis since last 10 days. She also had past history of recurrent chest infections. On examination, caved in appearance of anterior chest wall was seen with decreased air entry on left side in the infrascapular region. A chest radiograph was done which revealed dextrocardia with the left lower zone consolidation. So here is the chest x-ray. In the yellow arrow is the cardiac border with its apex towards right side representing dextrocardia, and a homogeneous opacity was noted in left mid and lower lung zone along the left lateral chest wall. After this, the patient underwent CCT thorax, the findings of which were as follows. Here is the axial CT section of the same patient. In this one section, we can see all the three rare congenital anomalies. Representing by the blue arrow is the incursion of the sternum into the mediastinum, suggestive of pectus excavatum. Green arrow representing the cardiac apex on the right side, showing dextrocardia. Then by the yellow arrow is represented a heterogeneously enhancing lesion in posterior basal segment of left lower lobe. Coronal sections of the same patient was taken and the findings are as follows. Here we can see cardiac apex on right side represented by violet arrow, but the abdominal viscera, that is the liver, represented by red arrow, and the spleen represented by yellow arrow on their respective right and left sides, that is the normal sides, ruling out situs inversus totalis. Then by the green arrow is represented the same area, the heterogeneous area in left lower lobe, which is along the left postal pleura and is also in contact with the left dome of the diaphragm. Also, we can see some feeding vessels which are supplying this area. These feeding vessels seem to arise from a branch of abdominal aorta. For the same patient, we constructed three-dimensional volume rendering images. Here we can clearly see an arterial feeder of the intralobar sequestration that is arising from the branches of celiac trunk. That is a branch of the abdominal aorta. So through these pictures, we came to know that cardiac apex was seen towards right side with no pulmonary hypoplasia or abnormality in the visualized sections of abdomen. Heller's index of the patient was more than 3.5 with sternal torsion angle of less than 30 degrees, suggestive of pectus excavatum. The patient was managed conservatively and was then referred to a cardiothoracic surgeon for the further managements. So bronchopulmonary sequestration is characterized by non-functioning pulmonary parenchyma comprising of normal lung elements which are arranged in a disorderly manner. It may or may not be connected to the tracheobronchial tree. When such a communication exists, repeated infections are very common. Also, it is of two types. It may be intralobar or extralobar, depending on whether it is inside the pleura or outside the pleura. The most common site for PPS is the left lower lobe, irrespective of whether it is intra or extralobar. The definitive treatment of pulmonary sequestration is surgical resection. Congenital anomalies are more associated with extralobar sequestration, which is seen in approximate 50% of the cases, but are very rare in intralobar type, which was present in our case. Next is the dextrocardia. टेक्स्टोकार्डिया कैन प्रेजेंट एज एन आइसोलेटेड अनोमली और मे बी एसोसिएटेड विद पल्मोनरी हाइपोप्लेजिया और कार्टेजेनस सिंड्रोम. हाउ एवर नो सच एसोसिएशन वॉज फाउंड इन आर पेशेंट. देन पेक्टस एक्सकेवेटर, इट इज मोर कॉमन इन मेल्स एंड इज ओकेजनली एसोसिएटेड विद माइट्रल वाल प्रोलैप्स, रेस्ट्रिक्टिव पल्मोनरी फिजियोलॉजी एंड डिफेक्टिव कार्डिक फंक्शन. वेयर एज इन आर पेशेंट पेक्टस एक्सकेवेटर प्रेजेंटेड जस्ट एज अ कॉस्मेटिक डिफेक्ट ओनली. So concluding my case, we present a rare case of combined intralobar bronchopulmonary sequestration with an atypical feeder from branch of the abdominal aorta, that is the celiac trunk, with dextrocardia and pectus excavatum. References for the same. Thank you.